anoint me in any distress, I will hear them, and I will be their Lord for in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We offer this Holy Mass to the glory of God, and so, brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbour, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he is still to be found, call him while he is still near. Let the wicked man abandon his way, the evil man his thoughts. Let him turn back to the Lord, who will take pity on him, to our God, who is rich in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, my ways not your ways. It is the Lord who speaks. Yes, the heavens are as high above earth as my ways are above your ways, my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm. The Lord is close to all who call him. The Lord is close to all who call him. I will bless you day after day and praise your name forever. The Lord is great, highly to be praised. His greatness cannot be measured. The Lord is close to all who call him. The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in love. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures. The Lord is close to all who call him. The Lord is just in all his ways and loving in all his deeds. He is close to all who call him, who call on him from their heart. The Lord is close to all who call him. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ will be glorified in my body, whether by my life or my death. Life to me, of course, is Christ, but then death would bring me something more. But then again, if living in this body means doing work which is having good results, I do not know what I should choose. I am caught in this dilemma. I want to be gone and be with Christ, which would be very much the better. But for me to stay alive in this body is more urgent need for your sake. Avoid anything in your everyday lives that would be unworthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessing on the King who comes in the name of the Lord. peace in heaven and glory in the highest heavens. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner going out at daybreak to hire workers for his vineyard. He made an agreement with the workers for 1 denarius a day, and then sent them to his vineyard. Going out about the third hour, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace and said to them, 'You go to my vineyard too, and I will give you a fair wage.' So they went, at about the sixth hour, and again at about the ninth hour, he went out and did the same. Then at about the 11th hour, he went out and found more men standing round, and he said to them, 'Why have you been standing here idle all day?' 'Because no one has hired us,' they answered. He said to them, 'You go into my vineyard too.' In the evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his bailiff, 'Call the workers and pay them their wages, starting with the last arrivals and ending with the first.' So those who were hired at about the 11th hour came forward and received 1 denarius each. When the first came, they expected to get more, but they too received 1 denarius. They took it, but grumbled at the landowner. 'The men who came last,' they said, 'have done only 1 hour, and you have treated them the same as us, though we have done a heavy day's work in all the heat.' He answered one of them and said, 'My friend, I am not being unjust to you. Did we not agree on 1 denarius? Take your earnings and go. I choose to pay the last comer as much as I pay you. Have I no right to do what I like with my own? Why be envious? Because I am generous. Thus the last will be first, and the first last.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The parable we have just heard about the men laboring in the vineyard is probably one of the most familiar of all the parables. Our sympathies spontaneously go to the fellow who labored all day, yet who receives the same salary as the one who labored for only 1 hour. But even so, we still realize that this parable is more about the generosity of God than about our perception of fairness. I imagine it was proving that the men in the parable were hired to carry out, but it can't have been very easy work, especially in the heat of the day. The man who was hired at daybreak would have had just cause to be envious of the man hired just an hour into the comparative cool of the evening. Let us turn our focus from the seeming injustice described in the parable to its actual setting. In the vineyard. Each one of us is called to serve in the vineyard of the Lord, which is the world around us. Each one of us has work to do for the Lord. We are Christians, after all, the followers of Christ on earth, and we carry on his ministry in the world today. We do what Christ did. We preach the good news of the kingdom. We heal the sick. We forgive the sinner. We spend time alone with God in prayer. We serve in his vineyard. We are his hands and his feet, and everything we do is done in his name. The world is our vineyard, and we care for the vines, its people. Metaphorically, we prune them, and we protect them from frost and from predation. Some have special roles as priests, others as catechists or teachers. But all of us are workers in the vineyard of the Lord. All of us are baptized and confirmed into ministry in imitation of the Lord and Saviour. And we find that it is a full-time occupation. Our Christian life, therefore, is not merely restricted to going to Sunday Mass and saying morning and night prayers. Our Christian life is like a seamless robe, because our every thought, word and deed, we intend to be an expression of our commitment to Christ. Our vineyard is the world around us. Not a few of us have been conscious of these things for a great number of years, but even our entire lives. We feel that we have done our duty, slaved tirelessly over decades for the sake of the kingdom. It is only natural that we might become a little envious of those who hear the call of the Lord only late in life. Like the man in the parable, we might harbour feelings that we are being unfairly treated, when we see latecomers treated exactly as ourselves. But when such feelings rise to the surface, We ought to instantly realise that we are entirely unworthy of being called Christian. These are the thoughts put into our minds by the evil one. Because often what we are actually meaning when we think such thoughts is that would have been really good if we had lived a life of sin, or at least lived a life apart from God and only chosen to embrace Him in the 11th hour. But when we expose this way of thinking to the daylight, we see how flawed it is. And we realise that we are truly blessed to have been chosen by God at all, let alone to have been called so early in our lives. We are indeed blessed and amply rewarded by God. He repays us for our labours with the joys of eternal life. In fact, there is nothing greater that He could give us. And indeed, He either gives us eternal life or nothing at all. So the reaction of the faithful and wise Christian is not to bemoan that so many come late, but to rejoice that they came at all. If we do need some human consolation, an extra pat on the back, then we should remind ourselves that what it is that we are about. Remind ourselves of the true nature of our work for the Lord. It is, of course, building up His kingdom here on earth and winning souls for heaven. With this understanding, every additional labourer coming into the vineyard of the Lord is another soul won for Christ. Every additional labourer is the result of the cumulative efforts of the entire church and a new outpouring of the grace and mercy of God. What greater cause of rejoicing could be that? Could there be that, no matter how late the hour, more and more are being recruited into the vineyard of the Lord and saved for life eternal? I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God's ways are not our ways, because His justice and generosity exceeds our strength. We come to Him. We can come to Him in prayer, knowing that He listens and that He will act. For Jonathan, our bishop, and all the bishops who serve God's people, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, for those nations where justice and freedom are denied to working people, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, for workers associated to maintain their rights and adjustments, let us pray to the Lord. The memory of Bill Bennett, Margaret Higginbottom, Madeleine Rimmington, John Ballin, Iris Pierce, Carol Brady, Rosemary Stapleton, Stephen Griffin, Carmen Holtzman and Keith Adams. For the long-term sick and housebound, George Wallace, Joan Mullins, Brian Keenan, Louisa Simpson, Angela Ellis and Kevin Newton. For those in hospital and hospices, nursing and care homes, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have died in Christ, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend ourselves and all God's faithful people to the intercession of the saints in heaven, but especially we ask the prayers of Mary, ever Virgin Mother of God. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. A few moments of silence. We offer to God our private petitions. Heavenly Father, you are near to all who call. Welcome our prayers with your generous care, and show us once more your abundant compassion. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
is that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. Receive with favour, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be there through these heavenly mysteries. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery he accomplished the marvellous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and dark angels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we attain. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Glory be to you, O Lord, that all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, all of you indeed of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take it, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Church, and recognize in the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servants Jonathan, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleased to endure their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our lives, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me. that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You are reminded, please, to take the sheets of the readings home with you rather than leaving them. That would be a great help, one less thing for me to worry about moving, cleaning, and all of that stuff, and gives you something to read during the week. Also, there will be a Mass on Monday and Wednesday at 9:30. Monday and Wednesday at 9:30, preceded by the Rosary, and on Friday evening at 6 p.m. again preceded by the Rosary. Became aware that there wasn't an evening Mass in the parish at the minute, so moving the Friday morning down to Friday evening. Bow down for the blessing. Keep your family, we pray, O Lord, in your constant care, so that under your protection they may be free from all troubles, and by good works show dedication to your name, through Christ our Lord. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
The angel of the Lord brought tidings from heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. We beseech you, Lord, for thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Nice to hear a bit of Handel. Yes. Very nice. Even my wife, who doesn't care for classical music, she likes it when I play the fireworks music.
Oh, yes.
You
yes. Yes, I quite like that.
Yes.
You need a rather good trumpet on the organ for that.
Yes, you do. Oh, yes. Yes.